Hey everybody, it's Marshall Mike here. This is gonna be my Girl Meets World episode. I can't really remember what episode this is because we've been on such a long break. Now the reason why I'm doing it in here, I know it's really echoey. I hate it. I don't like doing videos in here, but I decided I can't do them tomorrow. I'm trying to play catch up with all these videos ever since I've been on a long break. So, you know, now we're getting back to weekly TV, which means I gotta get back to all these videos. Plus, January is gonna be a huge month for TV with Suicide Squad, Batman v Superman, Wonder Woman stuff. And I already made a video about that, so go watch it. It's the Suicide Squad, Legends of Tomorrow stuff. You guys have probably already seen it, but if you haven't, go watch that. There might be a link up above, but I'm not really sure. But if not, it's in bonus videos, so go check it out. But anyway, yeah, we're gonna do this Girl Meets World video. A lot of stuff to talk about. I'm not gonna get it too long. I'm not even gonna do edits either. I'm just gonna get right to it. Let's talk about this episode. So basically, starting off with this episode, this one was kind of like another lesson. I feel like a lot of people are wanting them to go forward with the Maya Lucas story, Lucaya. I still get that name. I like saying Mucus as my ship name because I can remember that really easily. But I feel like a lot of people want to go on with that, with Charlie Gardner, all this stuff going on. I do agree with some of those people, except we can't do that every episode. It's like if you have, you know, an episode bunked, and it does the same thing over and over. Which it doesn't, but if it did, like, say, the first episode, if it just kept doing Welcome to Camp Kikiwaka every episode, or any other thing, like, if any other TV show that does the same theme each episode, it's not really interesting, but I just used Bunk as a reference. But anyway, you know, going back to Girl Meets World, we can't do that story over and over and over. We will get to that, because I feel like they're not done with that story, because it's one of the biggest things in the season right now, so they're not done with it. So I think they're going to just keep going on and on and on until they really establish what's the story. And then go on for as long as they want. Like, they could get together, Maya and Lucas, and then they can break up again. And maybe, you know, they can do a whole bunch of stuff. Because they've already proved to us that there's a lot of drama in this story. But that can't be every episode. You know what I mean? It just can't be. Which is weird to me because the New Year's episode kind of changed everything. I don't know why they're not following up on it, but like I said, it's just because they just can't do every theme over and over and over again. But anyway, talking about this episode, this one was really interesting because we got to see another class, another teacher, the science class. And this one was about really, you know, just kind of like one of those episodes. You know, a lot of TV shows do them, especially Disney, you know, with Zendaya did an episode kind of like this on Case Undercover, whereas girls can pretty much do everything that guys can do, which is what this episode is basically about. I mean, but it's kind of like not too much of that. I feel like a lot of TV shows that have done that theme have done it way too much, whereas Girl Meets World, I think, kind of did a really good amount on it. I don't know. I feel like this episode wasn't as good as others this season because we've got so many memorable cameos and returns from other favorite characters, but that's not really what Girl Meets World is all about. It's about their story, which is what we need to focus on. For this episode, it's kind of like, it's good. It's a good episode. It's a really good, you know, smooth episode. I feel like some of the things could have been improved. For instance, Ava. The actress who plays Ava, I think I don't necessarily like how she's acting. I know I never really say that about anybody who does TV because, you know, there are a lot of good actors out there. But I think that she in particular, I would have to say, I just can't. Because I feel like she's good, but she's not as great as the other actors. And I think she needs to get a little bit better at Ava. And I didn't really think Ava was really necessary for this episode because the story with her and Augie wasn't even that long. It was like 2 seconds long. And I feel like everything else, like, I feel like it was just not necessary. I feel like Ava at this point is not necessary for the story. So if you guys agree, comment down below what they're telling this season she's not really necessary for. Next season, we could have more Ava. But I feel like this season, since it's pretty much almost up, we only have, I think, a few episodes left. So I think that we need to cut Ava and focus on the core characters Maybe even Zay could be out of an episode as well and get back to the main four. You know what I mean? Because I feel like we haven't had like one of those episodes like that in a while, so I feel like we need to get back to that, which is really interesting. But, you know, the science experiment with Farkle, Riley had to drop the marble, which she did not do, and she kind of accomplished the story, which is clear in the science experiment. Kind of weird. I feel like the teacher was kind of weird. Anybody else get a weird vibe from him? But it doesn't really matter. But anyway, onto the other things. Farkle was a big thing in this episode as well. You know, does he believe in Riley? I don't know. And then we also got Brenda as well. We got Brenda as in Farkle basically dressed up in a wig. Yeah. But I hope you guys had a great time watching this, you know, voodoo, witch doctor, science, happy Deadpool, Chimichanga's Maya episode. Didn't anyone else pick up on that? Like, Maya, Deadpool, Chimichanga's. I feel like that was what she was just doing, the whole theme of the episode. Deadpool, Chimichanga's from a science witch doctor Maya was this whole episode. Like, sacrifice with Yogi, all that. That was hilarious. So I feel like Deadpool, Chimichanga's science witch doctor Maya has accomplished so much, which is really cool. But what do you guys think? So comment down below. Did anybody else pick up on that? Like, kind of like, that's what I thought was going. What if that was the case? Because technically Disney owns Marvel, even though Deadpool is in the, like, the Fox rights, it's still a Marvel character. So, I don't know. Maybe, I don't think they were trying to do that, but it's like, Deadpool, Chimichanga's Witch Doctor Maya has entered the building. I really like that. So what do you guys think? Comment down below. Don't forget to like and favorite this video. Don't forget to subscribe. Links up there to my other Grown-Ups World videos. Links down there to my Twitter, Instagram, Vine, vlog channel, Sims channel. Also, big announcement, Caden, if you guys know him, you pretty much probably already do by this point. He was on this channel, he's on my vlog channel all the time. If you guys don't know about him, he actually started his very own vlog channel called Caden Does Vlogs. I'll put a link up there for you guys to check out right now because it's amazing. The first vlog isn't really long, but we're going to get there because it's really cold and wintry. We don't really like to do big vlogs. Mine is actually today, my vlog is really short as well. But go check out his channel, his new one. So I'll go put a link right up there. Also, I'm going to be doing a huge monkey updates video on all the things that I'm going to start reviewing and stop reviewing. So check that out as soon as that's check that out as soon as that's uploaded. But thanks guys for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Bye bye.